Hi, I'm Stephen Whalen, and I'm here to talk to you about the merit-demerit system that will be put in place starting next week. Starting next week, the disciplinary actions will be based on a point scale, where you can gain points for doing bad things and lose points for doing good things. For example, as you can see, Kevin and David here are tardy to class. That would earn them one demerit. Go get to class. If you have an unexcused absence, that is also another call for a demerit. You! Do you have an excuse?
I regret this email.
Two demerits! Being out of dress code is also another call for a demerit. For example, demerit and demerit. You can also get a demerit for having visible earbuds. See, David here is enjoying his music like anybody could. But notice his earbuds? Neither do I. They're invisible. Now Kevin, he has earbuds. That's a demerit. That's a public display of affection. If you earn demerits, no worries. You can get rid of them by earning merits. This can be accomplished by doing something like picking up trash after school. No. Not white trash.
What?
You can also earn merits by voluntarily picking up trash in the lunchroom. Not white trash. Make sure you get rid of your demerits early. If you accumulate 8, you'll have a Wednesday's rule. And if you get up to 10, you'll be sentenced to pass.
Good morning, Apopka. Today is Friday, January 30th.
I'm Ryan.
And I'm Lauren, and this is the DNN.
The deadline to apply for next year's yearbook staff has been extended. See Ms. Springer, room 536, right away. Applications are now due February 10th.
Please congratulate the following students for winning medals in the Central Florida Debate Initiative Competition. India Grant, first place in Dramatic Interpretation of Literature. Ethan Ulig, third place in Lincoln Douglas. Sienna Handy and Cassie Bednar placed first in public forum. Chad Shavira and Case Nelson, second place in public forum. Marsha and Cynthia Manos, first place in duo interpretation of literature. Arnold Bourbon placed fourth in original oratory. Cameron Ernest and Quinn Larson won one round of public forum. Juliana Mazzaro won one round of Lincoln Douglas. Morgan Donahue and Artem Pimenov judge two rounds.
Hi, I'm DNN reporter Sierra Black, and today's Man on the Street question is, if you could do one thing to better Apopka High School, what would you do? Let's go find out. If you could do one thing to better Apopka, what would you do?
Change a lot of the students. Get rid of them.
Get rid of administrators.
For them to get Chipotle for lunch.
Have no school at all.
What I would do to make Apopka a better place is open a Chick-fil-A like right by the school. I'm tired of driving 15 minutes to go get some chicken.
I think some of those things could better Apopka. What do you guys think? This is DNN reporter Sierra Black going back to the studio.
Good morning, Apopka. This is DNN reporter Morgan.
Today's Man on the Street question that I will be asking around Apopka High School is, what is the favorite class you've taken at AHS?
Okay, my favorite class is English because I love to write, and Nikki is my favorite teacher.
My favorite class I've taken here is AP Psych.
My favorite class at AHS is PE. Shout out to Coach Taylor. Now.
My favorite class would have to be Mr. Bush's Spanish.
My favorite class is TV production.
What is your favorite class at AHS?
This is all for Man on the Street. This is DNN reporter Morgan Bornstein taking you back to the studio.
The Teen Express bus is coming February 9th, so make a note.
Seniors, we will be taking our big senior picture on the football field February 11th. Be sure to wear blue and white.
Senior bowling night is February 21st.
Bye, Apopka. Have a good day.
Good morning, Apopka. Today is Wednesday, January 7th.
I'm Carly.
And I'm Billy.
And this is the
DNN 5.
I don't like walking around this old and empty house.
So hold my hand, I'll walk with you, my dear.
The stars creak, I should sleep, it's keeping me awake.
It's the house telling you to close your eyes.
And some things I can't even trust myself.
It's killing me to see this way.
Attention 9th graders, you have the opportunity to enroll in the Medical Magnet for 10th grade. Medical Magnet will be having an open house on January 8th, tomorrow. The last day to enroll with the district is early February. There is an Engineering Magnet open house that night, too. Be there.
Be there, because that is like the best opportunity.
If you're cool,
if
you'd
you're
be
smart
there.
Like that. But anyways, there will be an Interact meeting Thursday right after school in room 422. All members should plan to attend. Set it on your calendar, your phones. You got to be there. Have to.
There will be debate practice this Friday right after school in room 422. Yearbook pictures will also be taken, so be there and look pretty. And now to a student spotlight video.
So lacrosse is a sport that was actually invented by Native Americans, and the best way to probably put it in terms for people to understand is that the game's pace is a lot like soccer, and the hitting is sometimes like football but with restrictions, and it's similar to hockey as well. So I'm a face-off midi, and basically what I do is after each goal that's scored or the beginning of a new half, me and another player, we fight for the ball, trying to get the ball for our team so we can score again. So basically my goals for lacrosse is for this year, I want to be at around 70% for my face-off percentage. I think that's what my team needs, and that's what one of my just personal goals is. And as far as a team, I want to be Brantley, and I want to be able to make an impact and kind of shock some people, because we're not considered powerful, but I think we have the capabilities to be so.
There will be a meeting on Thursday at 2:30 in room 507 for all boys and girls who will be trying out for the tennis team.
The drama department would like to announce auditions for The Secret in the Wings by Mary Zimmerman on Monday, January 12th, and Tuesday, January 13th. You must attend both days. Monday, you must perform a one-minute monologue that must be memorized and provide a resume. Tuesday, you must sing 1 minute of classical or musical theater song. You may use music if you wish. Wear something you can easily move in and no flip-flops or open-toed shoes. For more information, contact Miss Minor in room 836.
Do not drink soda.
My New Year's resolution is to be nicer to my sisters.
What's your New Year's resolution?
My New Year's resolution is to be a better student.
My New Year's resolution is to sleep less in class.
My New Year's resolution is to not depend on other people.
My New Year's resolution is to get all A's in my report card.
To get people at Apopka High School to listen to better music.
I call this one the Campfire Song Song. Let's gather around the campfire and sing our campfire song. Our C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G song. And if you don't think that we can sing it faster, then you're wrong. But it'll help if you just sing along.
Bum, bum,
bum. C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G song. C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G song. And if you don't think that we can sing it faster, then you're wrong. But it'll help if you just sing along. C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G song. Patrick!
Song! C-A-M-P-F-I-R-E-S-O-N-G song!
Squidward! Good! It'll help! It'll help! If you just sing along! Oh, yeah!
All right, Apopka, that's pretty much all we got for today. But seriously, don't forget about the exams next week.
Oh my gosh.
Well, there's a different schedule and stuff going on.
Every day.
I'm pretty sure the administrators will let you go.
All your teachers will have the schedule.
But goodbye, Apopka. Deuces.
Woo!
Good morning, Apopka. Today is Thursday, January 8th. I'm Molly.
And I'm Becca.
And this is the DNN. Attention ninth graders, you have the opportunity to enroll in the Medical Magnet for 10th grade. Medical Magnet will be having an open house tonight, and the last day to enroll with the districts is early February. There is an engineering magnet open tonight, too.
There will be an interact meeting today after school in room 422. All members should plan to attend. Be there.
There will be a debate practice Friday right after school in room 422. Yearbook pictures will be taken, so there and now to a student spotlight video.
So did you hear this?
The whole thing.
I know, it's right? Gone. It's gone.
So you want to do
yes.
This?
There'll be a meeting for all girls interested in lacrosse Thursday. After first period.
Right after first
during
period.
During RTI. In the cafeteria.
In the cafeteria. It's MTSS.
Yeah, MTSS. Okay.
Here's a trivia question for today. Where did Presidents George Washington, Andrew Jackson, Martin Van Buren, Zachary Taylor, Millard Fillmore, Abraham Lincoln, Andrew Johnson, Grover Cleveland, and Harry Truman all attend college? Any idea?
The answer to where all of those presidents of the United States attend college is nowhere. None of them went to college.
So there's hope for you. Yeah.
Yes. Going strong.
Mu Alpha Theta is offering math tutoring every Wednesday in room 545 immediately after school. Be sure to get the help before it is too late.
Too late. There will be a meeting today at 2:30 in room 507 for all boys and girls who will be trying out for the tennis team.
The drama department would like to announce auditions for The Secret in the Wings by Mary Zimmerman on Monday, January 12th and Tuesday, January 13th. You must attend both days. Monday, you must perform 1 minute monologue that must be memorized and provide a resume.
It's hard.
Tuesday, you must sing a 1 minute of a classical or musical theater song. You may use music if you wish, wear something you can easily move in, and no flip-flops or open-toed shoes. For more information, contact Ms. Minor in room 836.
And don't forget the cheerleading car wash on Saturday at Steak and Shake.
Steak and Shake.
In Apopka from 10 to 1. And now to a how-to video.
What's this whole battle of the books thing?
All right, the battle of the books, this is the first time that we've done it in high school. These are the 15 teen reads, and we just need 8 people on our team, and if they read all of these books, then they will, it'll be like a bowl. So they will answer questions with other high school members, and that's what we call the Battle of the Books, and it's in February. So we invite anyone that's interested. We're going to be meeting on Tuesdays after school to go over our questions. So join in the fun.
Career and technical enrollment is in full force.
Full force.
Please encourage your students to apply.
To apply.
Applications can be picked up at the lunch by the counselor corner, student services, and in room 117.
117. Now through Tuesday, January 13th, anyone interested in participating in the school spelling bee, the NEHS needs more spellers.
Spell that word.
Please come to our second day auditions on Tuesday, January 13th in room 612. Please come right after school.
Right after.
They really need you. They really do.
Attention writers, NEHS needs submissions for our next issue of Quote the Darter, the campus literary magazine. Please submit your stories, poems, or essays to Miss Rubio at jacqueline.rubio@ocps.net by Friday, 1:30. Or come see Miss Rubio in room 612.
We love you, Miss Rubio. Mu Alpha Theta is taking their big picture for the yearbook Wednesday, January 14th. Please wear your Mu Alpha Theta t-shirts, a black shirt or a teal shirt. Meet in room 545 immediately after school.
Immediately. Free science tutoring in room 541 every Tuesday after school.
Every Tuesday.
Every single Tuesday.
Get that tutoring done.
Goodbye, Apopka.
Don't forget that next week is final exams week with a different schedule every single day.
Every single day. Every single day. Yeah, don't go to the wrong class like me. Good morning, Apopka. Today is Friday, January 9th.
I'm Alana.
And I'm Jackie.
And this is the Quattro Squad. There will be a debate practice today right after school in room 422. Yearbook pictures will be taken.
So did you hear this?
The whole thing.
I know, right?
Gone.
It's gone.
So you want to do
Yes!
The drama department would like to announce auditions for The Seeker in the Wings by Mary Zimmerman on Monday, January 12th and Tuesday, January 13th. You must attend both days. Monday, you must perform a 1 minute monologue that must be memorized and provide a resume. Tuesday, you must sing a 1 minute song of classical or musical theater. You may use music if you wish, wear something you can easily move in, and no flip-flops or open-toed shoes. For more information, contact Ms. Minor in room 836.
I want to not be afraid of feet touching my feet.
Do you have any resolutions? I just want to continue taking care of myself and eating right and just staying happy.
Resolution is to do the exact same thing I did last
year. Resolution is to be a better person.
Resolution is to not eat junk food.
And don't forget the cheerleading car wash on Saturday at the Steak and Shake, Apopka.
Hi, this is DNN reporter Julia, and today's Man on the Street question is, what did you get for Christmas? Now let's go see.
Some phone cases and money.
I got the iPhone 7 X.
Hey, it is Christmas, man. I got an Audi truck, man. That baby sliding. Man, I got a Hummer truck. I got a lot this Christmas, man.
On the first day of Christmas, my mama came to me. Nah, I got a laptop, some beat headphones, some money, you feel me?
What I got for Christmas, I didn't actually get my present on Christmas. I got my present on New Year's Day, and that was my very first granddaughter, Harper Britt. And I'm very excited and very proud.
You guys had a very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Now back to the DNN.
Attention writers, NEHS needs submissions for our next issue of Quote the Darter, the campus literary magazine. Please submit your stories, poems, or essays to Miss Rubio at jacqueline.rubio@ocps.net by Friday, or come see Miss Rubio in room 612.
Well, last year, I was taking TV production just for the credit, and then this year, it clicked, and I was like, wow, I'm really good at this. I should keep going for it. And then I started videotaping, and it just got good from there. I don't know. My favorite thing about filming, I'd have to say, is being around the guys in lacrosse. I love the atmosphere, and then when I get to record them and see the satisfaction that comes from my videos that I make for them, I just love it. Everybody says I'm gonna be him, but I mean, I'm my own person, so no.
Mu Alpha Theta is taking their big picture for the yearbook on Wednesday, January 14th. Please wear your Mu Alpha Theta t-shirts or black t-shirt or a teal t-shirt. Meet in room 545 immediately after school.
of the DNN.
Good morning, Apopka.
Today is Monday, January 12th. I'm Lauren.
And I'm Selena.
And this is the DNN.
Woo!
The drama department has auditions for The Secret in the Wings on today, January 12th,
today.
And tomorrow, January 13th.
And tomorrow.
You must attend both days.
You must. It's a must.
For more information, contact Miss Minor in room 836.
Now through Tuesday, January 13th, anyone interested in participating in the school spelling bee, the NEHS needs more spellers.
Need more.
Please come to our second day of auditions on Tuesday, January 13th in room 612. Please come right after school.
We need to learn to
be
spell.
Be there.
We need to learn to spell. Attention writers, NEHS needs submissions for our next issue of Quoth the Darter, the campus literary magazine. Please submit your stories, poems, or essays to Ms. Rubio at jacqueline.rubio@ocps.net by Friday, January 30th, or come see Ms. Rubio in room 612.
I went to Miami and played softball for showcase.
Went to Universal.
Over winter break, I went to Disney.
For winter break, I went to Georgia.
Over Christmas break, I went to New Orleans, and I went to the Alabama game.
I went to live UCF over Christmas break.
For winter break, I went to the beach with all of my friends.
I went to Mexico.
I went to Miami.
I started a YouTube channel for my blog.
My family from Ohio came down, and they all went to light up UCF.
Over Christmas break, I went to Fort Lauderdale, and I met my cousin for the first time.
I went to St. Augustine.
Mu Alpha Theta is taking their big picture for their yearbook, for the yearbook, on Wednesday, January 14th. Please wear your Mu Alpha Theta t-shirts, a black shirt, or teal shorts.
It's supposed to be shirts.
Yeah.
Wear whatever shorts you want.
I don't know.
Guys, start it over.
Money.
All the money I got. That was my favorite Christmas present.
Well, my favorite Christmas present was my Lacoste bag.
That money, you already that dude.
The phone, because I've been wanting one.
The Xbox One.
My favorite Christmas present was nothing. I didn't get nothing for Christmas.
All boys interested in playing high school lacrosse, there will be physicals performed today at 6 p.m. Please email the team mom for location and details.
Team mom!
The first day for spring lacrosse practice is the following Monday, January 18th at 5 at the Fields of Fame off Poncan Road across from the Pop Warner Fields. There will be two meetings for prospective flag football players this week. Returning players will meet on Tuesday after school in room 503. New players will meet right after school on Wednesday in room 503.
Wednesday from 3 to like whatever time, and you better run over the weekend because the mile is not fun.
Ladies and gentlemen, and now
for
the Apopka
Freshman
of the Year.
The 2015 United States Army Player of the Year is Martez Ivey.
Being honored as the Player of the Year was by the U.S. Army. You know, I was shocked. You know, it wasn't something I was expecting. You know, I don't play for accolades or, you know, just for awards, you know. I play for my team, you know. So being awarded Player of the Year was, you know, when I look back on it, it's something kind of special, you know, because I play offensive line. And so, you know, being recognized as a Player of the Year for that, is, you know, you get overlooked by quarterbacks, your running backs, and your offensive and your defensive linemen, you know, and just... You know, it's rare. I mean, I think I'm the first one to ever win Player of the Year, you know, as an offensive lineman in high school. So I mean, that's something pretty special. Also to me, you know, I could be the first one. I could be the first one to say that. And yeah, it's also a blessing. You know, just it shows all the hard work you put in, and just, you know, everything you've done before, you know, the lead up to that point is paying off. The best thing about the trip, you know, being in San Antonio was, you know, going to the Children's Hospital and just spending time with, you know, some of the patients in there, and just, you know, to get back to them, you know, just because, you know, they're in the hospital all day, they're not really having fun or anything, and you know, they don't want to be there, they're little kids, and just so, you know, just to brighten up their day, you know, just put a smile on their face, you know. My favorite play in the game probably was a play called Mayhem. It was a play with me and Chandler, you know, we line up on the left side with the ball snap, and just, it's a trick play. It's like a double reverse pass, whatever. I don't even know what it was, but you know, it's just me and Chandler out there. Then we're blocking for the wide receiver to catch the ball, and just he run down the field, and just I remember seeing Chandler in front of me. You know, I was just like, I was thinking to myself, like, during as the play was going, I remember I was like, you know, this reminds me of Apopka right here. And so I blocked my guy, so I look back up and I see Chandler just lays his kid out. And I remember I was like, reminds me of Friday Night Lights, you know, at Apopka High School. But, you know, it was a great moment, you know, seeing Chandler and me, you know, just one more time at it, you know, just like, it's like we never get another chance to do that, you know, at the high school level. It felt kind of weird, you know, not to play with my football team, you know, I've been a part of for 4 years out of Apopka High School, you know, and, you know, not having those teams with me, you know, going into battle, you know, like strapping up during football, but, you know, it was a great opportunity, you know, get to play with other guys, you know, showcase your skills, get to other people in practice and other people, like some of the top players in the nation. It was a great experience, but it definitely didn't have that, you know, that brotherly feeling, you know, like we have at Apopka High School. I mean, there's no other place that at Apopka High School how we do it and how close we are.
Good morning, Apopka.
Today is Wednesday, November 19th.
That's Molly.
And that's Alyssa.
And this is the Quattro
Squad. The Science Honor Society offers free tutoring after school every Tuesday in room 541. Tutoring is available in all physics, physical science, and chemistry classes, including AP classes.
And now to a look at an after-school event.
Come to the Apopka Girls
Varsity Soccer Game!
Exclamation point! Yeah! Good job of getting y'all to move, pass the ball, make great decisions, but it can be better all the time. It can be better.
Do you owe any library book fines? Well, if you do, then bring any canned food items to the media center. They will take $1 off your book fine for every can you bring in. Scholastic Book Fair will be here through the 21st. What are you thankful for? Fill out one of the forms in the basket at the book fair and win free posters and books.
And now to a commercial for the media center.
Hi, it's Miss Mixon. We're here at the book fair, which is open from 7 to 3 every day. We take cash, credit cards, and checks. The best thing, though, is if you fill out what you are thankful for and place it in this basket, we do 2 drawings a day. You could win a free poster or a book, so come on in, check it out.
A meeting for all baseball players interested in playing spring baseball will be Thursday after school in room 1625 in the Science Building. The meeting will last about 15 minutes.
And now to a student spotlight and a highlight video from Mr. Klink.
Hi, I'm Elise Petrie. Welcome to my crib. Want to come in? Madrid, I'm signing to UAB.
Good morning, I'm Mr. Klink. I teach at Apopka High School, been here since 1987. I also coach swimming with Coach Russell, Coach Knudsen, and Coach Matthews. I had to go to Monmouth University this weekend, which is up in West Long Branch, New Jersey, right near New York and Asbury Park area. We had a swimming team that 40 years ago won a whole bunch of championships. They had All-Americans. They even had people that went on to win in the Olympics. So they honored our 1974 swim team and put us in the College Hall of Fame because of our achievements back then. So I was lucky enough to be on a team with these guys. We had some very interesting swimmers in those days. And what surprised me was how many of them went on to actually coach. And some of them are still coaching swimming at schools or at clubs. Something that I think if the students could understand that they can really learn a lot from their coaches because it can influence their life in the future, even for little part-time jobs like a swimming coach. So that's why I guess I do work with swimming today, because I did, you know, put my 4 years in college of swimming. It says here, Mr. Scahill wants to know, was I surfing in college? I sure was. I actually got to go visit my old surf spot on Sunday morning where I used to surf all the time. It says, how did I get from South Africa to Monmouth? Well, I was in Monmouth first. I went to South Africa, taught school there, and then I came back to Apopka, and I've been teaching here since I came back in 1987. It was a very enjoyable weekend. We were supposed to be introduced at halftime at the football game, which it was pouring rain and 40 degrees outside, so they did it inside. And then they had a banquet for us. Maybe she'll be able to show you a picture. They had a banquet for us in the hall where they filmed the movie Annie. So that was my weekend.
Key Club will hold its first meeting on Thursday, November 20th, immediately after school in room 632. All members should plan to attend.
All young ladies interested in playing spring fast pitch softball in January should have a physical on file with our training staff and should attend conditioning sessions on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays starting on December 1st. If you have any questions, see Coach McGuithy in room 550.
Have another great day at Apopka High School.
Bye, guys.
Bye, Apopka. Stay in school. Mm-hmm.
In. Yeah.
Meet fourth period, Quattro Squad.
Whatever happened to predictability? The milkman, the paperboy, evening, evening. You miss your old familiar friends waiting just around the bend. Everywhere you look, everywhere there's you a look.
Good morning, Apopka. I am Kyle.
My name's Jeff.
And this is the Quattro Squad. Now to the Senior of the Week.
Let's go find our Senior of the Week! Woo!
All junior and senior males, now is the time to show your Apopka High School spirit in the Mr. Darter pageant. The competition has any outfit of choice. You can wear anything, like mankinis are great. There's a talent category, a formal category, and a question and answer category. The overall winner of the pageant will be crowned Mr. Darter. Mr. Darter. And be awarded with a prom ticket.
Trials for track are Thursday the 22nd at 2:30 in the stadium. Trials begin tomorrow. Now to the man on the street.
Good morning, Apopka. This is DNN reporter Christopher. Today's man on the street question that I'll be asking around Apopka High School is, if you could change one thing about the dress code, what would it be?
Being able to wear crop tops.
I'm Abdias, and if I could change one thing on the dress code, it would be tank tops.
I'm Jordan, but the thing I would change about dress code is that guys can wear tank tops.
My name is Brianna. If there's one thing I could change about the dress code, it'd be for me to wear shorts.
I'm Morel, and if I could change one thing about dress code, it would probably be the shorts.
This is all for Man on the Street. This is DNN reporter Christopher taking you back to the studio.
Good morning, Apopka. This is DNN reporter Sarah Pitts. Today's Man on the Street question that I will be asking around Apopka High School is, what is your favorite and least favorite thing about Apopka High School?
Favorite thing about high school, Apopka High School, is probably the school spirit, and my least favorite thing is the bathrooms because they're really disgusting.
High school is the school spirit, and my least favorite thing is the cafeteria food because it's not.
My favorite thing about Apopka High School is the athletic department, and my least favorite thing is the food.
The thing about Apopka High School is like how it's like a family feel.
My least favorite thing is that it's so outdoors, like there's no inside in here. If it's hot, then I'm hot. Like, I don't know if that made sense.
My favorite thing about Apopka High School is the sports and school spirit, and my least part is probably education.
Thanks for those opinions. This is all for the Man on the Street. This is DNN reporter Sarah Kuhn taking you back to the studio.
Good morning, Apopka. This is DNN reporter Samantha. Today's Man on the Street question that I will be asking around Apopka is, do you prefer to use hand dryers or paper towels? Let's see what people have to say.
They made machines for paper towels because if you use a dryer, y'all got to stand in line. If you use a paper towel, everybody's just mad and throw it.
Paper towels. Hand dryers.
Oh, cat. So, blow dryers.
Thanks for those opinions. That's all for Man on the Street. This is DNN reporter Samantha taking you back to the studio.
Goodbye, Apopka.
Goodbye,
have a
Apopka.
Great day.
Quattro
trivia
squad.
Night, Thursday.
Thursday.
Be
dude,
there.
Trivia crack?
Or be square.
Nothing on it. Be circular.
Of the DNN.
Good morning, Apopka.
I'm Billy.
And I'm Selena.
And this is the DNN. Attention, all junior and senior males. Now is the time to show Apopka High School how much school spirit you have in the Mr. Darter pageant. The competition has any outfit of choice, talent, formal category, and question and answer. The overall winner of the pageant will be crowned Mr. Darter and awarded with a ticket to prom.
You're special.
I'm going to do it. I'm Mr. Darter. I'm talking about.
Tryouts for track are today at 2:30 in the stadium.
My name is Michael Delgado, and I'm a junior here at Apopka High School. I've been in band for almost 6 years, and I play clarinet, bass clarinet, contrabass clarinet, tenor saxophone, and barry sax. This is a bass clarinet, and I've been playing it for almost 5 years. The best thing about band, I would have to say, is the Friday night games. Also, I liked being tenor saxophone section leader last year, and I also like doing All County, which would be my third year performing, and I will be performing for my third time at the end of the month.
The debate will meet Friday after school in room 422. All competitors should attend, and candy money should be turned in as well.
Interact will meet Thursday after school in room 422. All members should attend to help plan for the blood drive.
Applications for next year's yearbook staff are now available. See Ms. Springer in room 536 right away. Applications are due January 30th.
Damn. Juniors and seniors, anyone interested in auto, diesel, motorcycle, or marine machines? That's kind of cool, like marine machines. A representative from Universal Technical Institute will be visiting Apopka High School on Monday, January 26th at 1 p.m. If you would like to hear the presentation, you may sign up on the College Visit Board and Student Services.
If you're interested in Bud Asher's clinic on the fundamentals of kicking, punting, and long snapping, check with Coach
Ketron.
Yeah, by Friday.
My name's Serena Munoz, and today's Man on the Street question is, what college do you plan to attend and why?
I'm going to Westside Tech to get my cosmetology license, my esthetician license, because I want to be a beautician and own my own salon.
What college do you plan on attending and why?
I plan on attending Embry-Riddle because I can afford it, and I plan on flying planes.
I plan on attending UCF. I mean, because ever since I was little, I wanted to go there, and I think it's amazing.
Okay. Okay, so I've been thinking about going to UF because I probably want to study sports medicine.
I plan on going to UF because so many fine women. Yes.
that concludes
our Man on the Street question.
Good morning, Apopka. This is Dean and reporter Gracie Darlington. And today's Man on the Street question is, how do you feel about the class of 2015? Let's go find out.
Wilson, how do you feel about the class of 2015?
I like them.
Far early.
Class of 2015 is pretty attractive, if you ask me.
Yes, I do like the senior class.
2015 are very childish. Talk about 2016. I wish them the best of luck. Thank you.
I love my class, actually. We're all crazy and fun, and we did bring you guys the powder toss, so you're welcome.
Apopka, those are some opinions about the senior class.
Good morning, Apopka. This is DNN reporter David Gomez. Today's Man on the Street question that I will be asking around Apopka High School is, what superpower would you have, and why? Sir, what superpower would you have, and why?
I would fly because I can fly. Like, have you ever wanted to fly?
Yes. Yes, thank you. Hey!
If you had to pick, what superpower would you have and why?
Time travel, so I could go back and make sure that I'm ready for everything.
Great answer.
Help me.
Shit.
Hey!
Oh my god!
What superpower would you have, sir? And why?
The power to pass through solid objects because all these delicious snacks are mine.
Good answer. Those are some great answers, Apopka. I really liked them. Personally, how would you answer? This is DNN reporter David Gomez, signing out.
How much school spirit you have in the daughter pigant? Wait, real quick.
Pageant. Y'all do not know.
Pageant, you moron! Oh. College.
Good morning, Apopka. Today is Friday, January 23rd, 2015. I'm David Whalen.
And I'm Charlie.
And this is the David Whalen Show.
Featuring the unicorn.
Attention all juniors and senior males. Now is the time to show Apopka High School how much school spirit you have in the Mr. Darter Pageant competition. The competition has any outfit of your choice, talent, formal category, and question and answer. The overall winner of the pageant will be crowned Mr. Darter and the award and be awarded with a ticket to prom.
Reminder that the debate team will meet today after school in room 422. All competitors should attend and candy money should be turned in as well.
Young Hefe, Holmes.
Come to the game tonight. Come support the boys in blue at 7:30 tonight.
And we're performing.
So yeah, you know, you're
in the camera woman.
Yeah, I'm trying to camera all your videos.
Go ahead.
Be there tonight. What else?
Tonight. Or beware or beware.
Yeah, so that's the answer.
Oh, you already know. We know Brian. No, not Brian, but me and I know. Night. Get it on.
So sup? I'm out. I'm out. God, pull up in it. Oh my.
This past Tuesday, the FFA competed in the District 7 contest, placing first, beating East River High School. Now they will move on to the state competition in June. Congratulations to Eric Archer, Amber Bray, Jake Dombush, Haley Maxwell, Nicholas Schollenberger, and Alexa Wandry. I'm sorry if I mispronounce any names.
Applications for next year's yearbook staff are now available. See Ms. Springer in room 536 right away. Applications are due January
30th. Anyone interested in auto, diesel, motorcycle, or marine mechanics, a representative from the Universal Technical Institute will be visiting Apopka High School on Monday, January 26th at 1 p.m. If you would like to hear the presentation, you may sign up on the college visit board in student services.
If you are interested in Bud Archer's Clinic of the Fundamentals of Kicking, Punting, and Long Snapping, check with Coach Catron by Friday.
Attention college athletes! Do you want to get recruited? Do you want scholarship offers? Then come to the NCAA Information Meeting Tuesday, January 27th. At 7:30 p.m. in the AHS auditorium.
Several DNN reporters went out to the student body to ask some important questions. Let's take a look at some men on the streets.
Good morning, Apopka. This is DNN reporter Mackenzie. And today's man on the street question is, do you think anything you learn at Apopka High School will help you when you graduate? Let's see what they have to say.
Yes, I think the medical program will help me after I graduate because that's what I want to be when I grow up.
Yes, I do think some of my classes will help me with my future career to prepare me in my life.
No, because I don't honestly, I don't see the meaning of biology and all that stuff. Why do I need it? I'm not going to use it ever again.
Yes, because all the teachers and coaches are amazing.
Yes, because trivia crack has a lot of stuff from school, so that really helps me in life.
It gives me smarticle particles.
and Apopka High School has given me a great education, especially in my vocabulary.
No, because I don't pay attention half the time.
Those were all interesting answers. This is all for the man on the street. This is DNN reporter Kenzie taking you back to the studio.
My name is Lavanda Hope. I'm in the 12th grade. I was crowned homecoming queen of Apopka High School this year, and this is Danielle. I am a captain of the Apopka High School Color Guard. You lift my heart up when the rest of me is down. You enchant me, even when you're not around. I like to sing to y'all. Also, I have been a chorus member of the school of Apopka with all the highs for 4 years. This was my senior spotlight. It's not a picture, it's a video.
Have a great weekend, Block. Go watch,
to the basketball game.
Shoot some hoops.
7:30.
Toss the rock. Sports. Yeah.
Today is Monday, January 26, 2015.
This is the Quattro Squad.
I'm Emily.
And I'm Gabby, and this is the DNN.
Attention all junior and senior males. Now is the time to show Apopka High School how much school spirit you have in the Mr. Darter pageant, or as Miss Billy Coggle would say, pagant. The competition has any outfit of choice, talent, formal category, and question and answers. The overall winner of the pageant will be crowned Mr. Darter and awarded with a ticket to prom.
Applications for next year's yearbook staff are now available. See Ms. Springer in room 536 right away. Applications are due January 30th.
Attention college athletes. Do you want to get recruited? Do you want scholarship offers? Then come to the NCAA Information Night tomorrow at 7:30 p.m. in the auditorium.
Several DNN reporters went out to the student body and asked some important questions. Let's take a look at some man on the streets.
Good morning, Apopka. This is DNN reporter Janita Muniz. Today's Man on the Street question that I will be asking around school is, if you could change one thing about Apopka High School, what would it be?
It would be the grading scale, the 90-10 rule, because, yeah, it brings grades down a lot, very dramatically and drastically, so, yeah.
It's a time to start. I need my beauty sleep and all that stuff, you feel me?
If I could change one thing about school, it would be more time between the classes.
It's probably the food, yeah. And it's a little early. So.
That is all for the man on the street. This is DNN reporter Janice Mina taking you back to the studio.
Literary magazine, Quote the Darter, still needs submissions from writers. Any student may submit writing such as stories, poems, and essays. Please email your submissions to Ms. Rubio at jacqueline.rubio@ocps.net or stop by and see her in room 612.
Financial aid night is today at 6 p.m. in the auditorium.
Any boys interested in playing volleyball this season, please attend the information meeting today after school in the gym. If you have any questions, see Coach Sanders in room 515.
Good morning, Apopka. This is DNN reporter Cassidy Johnson. Today's Man on the Street question that I'll be asking around Apopka High School is, what do you think is the main priority of teams today?
I think the main priority for teams is like social media.
I believe the main priority for teams today is, since social media is like so big, they feel like they have to fit in with every single thing, whether it be good or bad.
I feel like the main priority of teens today is the internet, because they're always on their phones, they're using social media, they're listening to music, and they're texting their friends.
What I think the main priority for teenagers today is probably social media or who's texting them.
It's just to have fun.
So how would you answer, Apopka? That's all for the Man on the Street. This is DNN reporter Cassidy Johnson taking you back to the studio.
I've always been the kind of girl that hid my face, so afraid to tell the world what I've got to say. But I have this dream right inside of me. I'm gonna let it show. It's time to let you know. It's to let you know. This is real. This is me. I'm exactly where I'm supposed to be now. Gonna let the light shine on me. Now I found who I am. There's no way to hold it in. No more hiding who I wanna be. This is me.
Good morning, Apopka. Today is Tuesday, January 27th. I'm Carly.
And I'm Riley.
And this is the DNN.
Attention, all junior and senior males. Now is the time to show Apopka High School how much school spirit you have in the Mr. Darter pageant. The competition has any outfit of choice, talent, formal category, and question and answer. The overall winner of the pageant will be crowned Mr. Darter and will be awarded with a ticket to prom. Raise the roof.
Applications for next year's yearbook staff are now available. See Ms. Springer in room 536 right away. Applications are due January 30th. And now to a senior of the week.
Let's go find our senior of the week! Woo!
Awkward.
Do we have a null or T?
No.
There we go.
How does it feel to be senior of the week?
Attention, college athletes, do you want to get recruited?
No.
Do you want scholarship offers? Then come to the NCAA Information Night tonight at 7:30 in the auditorium.
Several DNN reporters went out to the student body to ask some important questions. Let's take a look at some man on the streets.
Very important.
I'm Ms. Cookweaver, and I'm one of the assistant principals here, and the word to me that best describes Apopka would be family.
And I would describe Apopka the one word, complex.
Okay, my name is Anna Echevarria, and to describe Apopka in one word, I would say blue.
Good morning, Apopka. This is DNN reporter Allie Hay. Today's Mail on the Street question that I will be asking around Apopka is, what is one thing you would do if you were principal for a day? Let's see what people had to say.
If I was principal for a day, I would make sure that Jacob McKay and Princess Salazar had a class.
every single class together because they have their love for each other is unbreakable.
Hey, I'm Jordan. And if I was principal for a day, I'd probably like just let everybody go to their two favorite electives and then go home after that. That's it.
Hi, my name is Andrezia, and if I was principal for a day, I'd make the vending machines open because people be getting hungry in the middle of the day.
Hi, I'm Zion. If I was principal for a day, I think I would make a mandatory free period to just chill out and do what you like. It's your time.
Hi, I'm Kelsey, and if I was principal for a day, I'd probably put Gatorade in the water fountains and go to the girls' basketball games. And Molly, what's that girl? What's up?
Those were interesting answers. That's all for Man on the Street. This is DNN reporter Ali Haig taking you back to the studio.
Literary magazine Quoth the Darter still needs submissions from writers. Any student may submit a writing such as stories, poems, essays. Please email your submissions to Ms. Rubio at jacqueline.rubio@ocps.net or stop by and see her in room 612.
Bye, Apopka!
Bye, Apopka. Peace and blessings!
Good morning, Apopka.
Today is Thursday. I'm Alexis.
And I'm Gabby. And this is the Quattro Squad.
The deadline to apply for next year's yearbook staff has been extended. See Ms. Springer in room 536 right away. Applications are now due February 10th.
There will be no debate practice tomorrow due to a previously scheduled AP conference. Students should practice their cases during class and at home. Check with Ms. Boston Brown for questions.
If you would like to be on the blue and white newspaper staff next year, see Ms. McLeod in room 539 before February 4th.
Several DNN reporters went out to the student body to ask some important questions. Let's take a look at some man on the streets.
Hi, I'm Henry Barber, and today we're asking people how they show their school spirit. Today I'm here with Zach, and Zach, how do you show your school spirit?
I wear blue on Fridays and go to the football games.
Brian, how do you show your school spirit?
Well, like I attend the school. That's how I show it.
Thanks, man. Aria, and how do you show your school spirit?
I go to the games every Friday.
Today I'm here with Juan. How do you show your school spirit?
I show it in many different ways. I'm pretty much the happiest person on this campus. I go cuckoo.
How you show school spirit?
Well, at the football games, I dance in the stands. Like, show my hood.
That's how people out of Apopka show their school spirit.
The Teen Express bus is coming February 9th, so make a note.
Seniors, we will be taking our big picture on the football field February 11th. Be sure to wear blue and white. Class of 2015.
Senior bowling night is February 21st.
I come to tell you that the MCAT is around the corner. It's right around the corner. Come March, you will have to take the MCAT. 10th, 9th, 11th, and some of y'all 12th graders. You gotta take the MCAT. You might not know when, you might not know how, but I come to tell you that you gonna have to take it anyway. You might not want to. You might wake up, sleeping in your eyes, but I come to tell you, the MCAT is here. It's right around the corner.